after making such a huge productions and huge scale proposals, I was so happy to see how such a different situations could inspire me to expand our thinking from the Serpentine. Serpentine is already quite experimental, but from the Serpentine things, I never expected such a different scales, different shapes, and different situations could happen. So I felt the potentials of the thinking, our thinkings, could have more, how to say, the different scales, skyscrapers, or 1.2 kilometers shopping spaces. Everything is continuously developing. And every time I do these kind of lectures, yeah, I look for the clients to realize this project together. So if some of you have money and very interested in this project, please just let me know for the amazing collaborations. Okay, let's go back to the quite smaller, one of the smallest project I did. This is the public toilet in Japan. One of the minimal public toilet, like this. There you could see the toilet with a glass box. And we designed also this display, because from above it's like this. So it's a glass box, but we designed also the wall surrounding this area. And we have a door here, around here. And once you come in, you can lock the door on here. So this is a kind of a private gallery, once you lock it. Because the public toilet is, for me, it's quite interesting topic for architectural thinking, because it's public, but once you are inside, it's private. So the public and private, how to deal with these kind of opposite things, and how to create something between the public and the private. That's one point. And the site is in the countryside and beautiful sceneries. So it's nice to see the view, but of course, at the same time, you have to block the view from around it. So how to block, how to protect, and how to open? It's also quite classical, fundamental question about architecture. Once you make a wall and windows, that question happened, started long, long time ago. And still, we are questioning how to protect it and how to open it. And this time, we just do the simple solutions. We use the two different types of the wall. Normally, the wall is wall, but sometimes the wall could block the view. And sometimes wall could block the air. And we divided the meanings or functions of the wall in two different walls. This wall, not blocking the view, but blocking the air to create the minimal protected areas. And this black wall, just blocking the view, but not blocking the air. So even inside this black wall, this is outside. It's open field. And then we made a distances between this and this to create the like a contradictional situation. You are protected from the view around it, but you can enjoy the view to the surroundings. It is possible, it sounds very like a contradiction, but it's possible. If you carefully see the meaning of the walls, the re-questioning what is the wall, and then carefully lay out the two different walls with a certain distance, then it's possible. So it sounds like a funny joke, but it is quite serious re-questioning about what is architecture, and what is private, what is public, and what is open, and what is protect. And this is a plan, so it's quite simple. This is the black wall, and this is the glass box, and this is the door. And so it is quite functional, I believe, except when you are in emergency situations, it's a bit tough. Finally, you run in front of the door, and you open the door, and then you will see another 10, 15 meters to run. So, in that case, it is not so functional. But normally, I think this is kind of the extreme solutions in such a situations. In the countryside, the public toilet, but you like to enjoy the openness of the view, but you like to protect yourself. So this is the quite simple extreme solutions. It's quite simple. And we keep the inside, it's like a not fancy garden, it's more like a just as it is. And we keep the existing tree like this to make it almost like the same as surroundings. So it is quite like a surreal situation, but I can say even in such a quite small, tiny, strange project, we can do such kind of a re-questioning. What is architecture? What is the meaning of architectures? What is the potentials of the architectures? Something like that. And this house also dealing with how to do with the boundaries. The toilet was the simple question, how to do with the boundaries. And the boundary question is always, I would say, the main topic, one of the main topics for architecture. And this house is a private house. It is made by quite simple compositions. Big box, middle box, and small box. So box house with many, many openings. But the openings on this big box has no glass. So it's like a rain comes in and wind go through it. So this part inside of this big box is outside. And this middle box has a skylight glass and the windows. So inside of this middle box is inside, but still outside of this small box. So if you have, normally we have one walls to divide inside and outside, but if you have three layers, then suddenly the definition of the inside and outside starts to blur, could get really ambiguous. Where is definitely inside? Where is definitely outside? And then we can take it in a positive way, to create those kind of, this is actually outside, but still like a surrounded by the box, big box. So it's like another room for you, really kind of a biggest room in your house, bigger than your actual house. So it's kind of, this kind of in-between space things could provide you is more choice, I believe. I think this is more ideal situation of the boundaries. Then, because you could have a choice, getting more and more inside, private, enclosed situations, or if the weather is fine, you can go more like this, but slightly protected. Or you could choose, or in between situations, or rather come inside, or rather come outside, depending on the weather, or depending on your feelings, or depending on how many friends you are, or something like that. So, as I said, in the house with many, many different floor levels, it is nice to provide the choices for people, the varieties and variations and the diversities in your house. It could be the rich living environment, I thought. So not just making the one wall to create to make the situation too simple, but to create more like ambiguous, positive ambiguous situations to provide more choice. That was the strategies of this house. And then the plan was very simple. Big box, middle box, and small box. And section is also big box and middle box, small box. Especially this section is crazy because normally this is the house, actual house. This is just an enclosure, enclosing the air in a sense. So in a normal meanings, it is useless. But if you have it, then you could have the richness of the layering, the richness of these gradations, and then you could have something more than what it is. So that was the moment I thought, wow, this could be, normally it's useless and out of the functions, but actually it could make something more than the normal house. And then finally it's realized. Once you're coming in, then this is outside, so you have trees, but still covered by the enclosure with no glass, so you could see the sky. And from the very small box in the middle, you can see small box openings and middle box and big box and the cloud. So those kind of layers. And it is quite amazing because you can see the four skies already like a particles of the skies. In actual situation, you have more skies, 10, 15 skies are surrounding you. So it's quite open feelings. But at the same time, you feel three layers of the wall are protecting you. So it's quite nicely protected situations, but at the same time, really nicely open situations. So again, how to open and how to close, protect, has been the really, really important question for thousands of years. And this one is like a duality or coexistence of the openness and closeness. And you could choose, when you move around, some corner you feel more protected because of the position, layering of the windows. Some corner is really, really protected. And some corner you feel really, really open. So it is up to you. You could choose moving around to find your comfortable spaces. So it is not something beyond the normal functional definitions. Normally this is dining space, living space, something like that. Such a rough definition. But we could say, from now we could say, this corner or these areas could be rather open or could be rather closed. From 0 to 10, you can say this is maybe 2.5 openness. This is more like a 6.5 protected feelings. So the functions could be redefined by that kind of how open and how closed, how protected areas. Because our life is quite complex, I think. And the functionality is too much roughly defining our behaviors. And our behaviors is much more than the dining spaces or bedrooms. So I try to redefine what is the field for the people's life and try to provide as much options, as much varieties for their choice, for our choice as possible. And again, this is the garden. The kind of the place of the nature and architecture, artificiality and the nature things. And this is also quite like inspired by the Japanese traditional thinking of the in-between spaces to create the nice interface between the outside, inside and the nature and architectures. To re-translation of the traditional things of the contemporary life. And this library also dealing with the layering, but not only inside and outside, but within inside, it has the layering of the situations. This is a library for the Art University in Tokyo. And mostly the old walls are covered by the bookshelves. So we can say this library is only made by the one continuous bookshelves. It's like a spiral, getting bigger. But the important point is it has many openings on these bookshelf walls, like the previous box house. And then you can see another layer, next layers, through these openings, and then next layers throughout these openings. But you can feel the space behind it, or behind it, but you don't see exactly what is happening there, because mostly it's protected or blocked by the bookshelves. Only limited openings are showing you something is happening there. Because I was at the dispersal competition and at the presentation, I make the proposals. This library could be the forest of books. Because of course the library is really functional space. You have to find the systematic layout of the books to find the books. But at the same time, I thought it's nice to walking around, meandering around in the forest-like spaces, and sometimes unexpectedly you encounter with some unknown books or some new ideas or something like that. That could be also really nice definition of the library, I thought. But it was quite tough challenges because the systematic layout is not making the forest-like meandering spaces because it's too clear. But at the same time, I like to create those kind of a rather not chaotic, but the really complex situation of the forest. So try to combine them together by these kind of a layering compositions. So because of this kind of a layering, you feel something behind the spaces, but you don't know what it is. And those kind of expectations or some inspirations came out from all around. And then you start to walk around, different layers, different viewpoints could open. It is like endlessly walking around in that. So this is a model. And you could see how the whole bookshelf walls are spiraling, surrounding you. And some of the openings you can walk through, and some of them you cannot walk through it, just you can see it. And even outside, it has a bookshelf covered in glass. And once you're inside, you see this is one of the big openings, one layer, and another layer. This is almost the end of the library. So you see another layer outside. But once you walk up to the main floors, you see so many layers of the bookshelves with many, many openings. So it's almost like an endless process. You find out new space behind this wall, but from that new space, you could see another perspectives, another something behind it. So it's like a inspire you to walk around. And those huge numbers is the signage to show the categories, each category. 9 is the literature, and the 7 you can find, this 7 is the art. And this is, I think, a 2. It's something like philosophy or something like that. So this kind of a huge signage is telling you where is the categories and what kind of a layout it has. So it is systematically created. But if you don't care about those kind of, the layout of books, just like to walking around to get more inspirations, then those two huge signage is not like, looks like a signage. So not force you to follow to the signage. It's just like one of the part of the art pieces or something like that. So those kind of different perceptions, different situations, different perceptions, different meanings of space are created. And mostly the students sleep in the library. Yeah, of course I like this photo very much because she is representing how comfortable this space is. But actually, this size of the space between the two walls is about 4 meter or 4.5 meter. So it's like a cozy residential scales. It is creating a nice, comfortable areas for reading books or for sleeping. But at the same time, the same geometries could create those kind of a really infinite layers on the bookshelves. It is almost like these walls maybe could be the last walls. Exterior walls, but you don't know which one is the end. You couldn't see the actual ending point. So you feel the whole space is much larger than the actual boundaries of this building. It is quite amazing point of this kind of architectural design. Architecture is fixed, not moving. Architecture has a specific size itself, but your experience is sometimes much more than the actual size of the buildings. If you are in here, you feel double size of the spaces surrounding you because you don't see the end. Then you start to walk around, you lose the geometry feelings. And then finally, almost like endless walking around processes make you much, much bigger experiences than the actual spaces. Or the whole same spaces, sometimes depending on your viewpoint or depending on your purpose, huge expanding spaces, 5,000 square meters or something. Or the same space could feel like your study room, your residential spaces. So from the small scales to the larger scales, not just providing the varieties, but for the perceptions of the peoples, we could create those kind of transitions of the scales by that. So architecture design could have a lot of potential because of those kind of experiences, and physical things could be always different, and the physical experiences could be beyond the actual architectural size or spaces. Yeah, the same things happened at the first project Serpentine. Everything is fixed, made by the steel, heavy, but following to your experiences, everything is, looks like moving around, changing, gradually changing around, soft impressions. And once you choose your sitting places, then the whole things are like, looks like a, for that purposes. But of course, the next day, different weather, different situations, together with your different friends, then the whole meaning of the spaces will always change. So yeah, I think we can try to create such kind of a potential of the experience of architecture beyond the actual architectural spaces. So three more projects. Those are recently we won a competition in Europe, in abroad. Two in France and one in Budapest, Hungary. And this is the project in France, south of France, to create a high housing tower. And yeah, this is like this. And of course, you can see south of France, very good weather. And even in the winter time, they have a lunch. They could have a lunch on the terrace outside. And mostly their lifestyle is not interior, but more exterior. So we try to translate those kind of a traditional south of France lifestyle into the contemporary high-rise architecture. And finally, our strategy was very simple, to put huge balconies sticking out like this, and shadings, to provide as much outdoor terrace space as possible. And it is really sticking out. The longest one is the 8-meter cantilever coming out. So it is quite, in a sense, it's quite classical typology, the apartment and balcony. So it's just a normal. But if we could have the right place, the south of France, and the right strategies, and the right shape of the buildings, so if the building itself is like a softly shaped, then such a classical concept of the apartment and balconies could change into something new, something new. And the shape itself was defined finally by the site conditions. At the starting point, we thought about just a rectangular box. These are normal bodies. And then, of course, the ideas of the big balcony came out in a very, very early phase. And we put the balconies on this kind of a rectangular box. But it looks like a kind of a quite messy. It's like a toothbrush or something like that. So we thought, wow, this idea, this is not the things. And we just thrown away somewhere. And then we go back to the more basic studies of the site conditions. This is the site, and this is the river, and this is a green area, green park alongside the river. And this is also the existing green. So naturally we thought about, okay, this green should be connected like this. So we push the building more onto the roundabout area. And this is the existing building. So we like to have keep the view as much as possible. Of course, not the full view, but as much as possible. So we cut this corner a little bit like this. And then this side also to make a more like a harmonized, symmetrical shape. So finally, we had this kind of a strange shape. And then we go back to the original ideas of the huge balconies. This time, not just putting onto one side, but more like a, all around these soft-shaped buildings, we put the balconies. And then, again, it's a quite normal strategy, but it looks quite different, looks quite new. It's something like a different environment or different creatures, like a pine cone or something. And then we thought, wow, this is economically, of course, this makes sense. And as a strategy, it's quite classical, but really nicely fitting to the local situations, their lifestyle. And still, it is quite something new. And then we decided to do that, and developer like that ideas. And finally, we won at the competitions. And yeah, not only one balcony, but the two, three balconies are sticking out from one apartment. So it is really like actual outdoor living spaces. And sometimes, yeah, here you can see the apartment itself is a duplex, two levels, and then the balcony itself, two levels, larger, connected by the staircases. So outside two stories, inside two stories, both of them are connected together by the staircases. So it's quite like a three-dimensional actual space for the life. Nice view to the Mediterranean Sea. And yeah, it's in front of the river, a beautiful view. Now we start construction next month. In a few weeks, next week. And we'll be finished 2018, I think. But yeah, of course, this is like a beautiful view, but I am expecting after the completions, when the people start their life, they bring out many parcels or furniture or something like that, their daily stuffs. And then the whole buildings will be covered by such a, I would say, varieties of the different lifestyle of them. That could be quite a fantastic moment, I believe. I don't want to make the architecture as it is like this, but I like to create the field or place for their life, or place for new life. And in this case, new but connecting to the traditional lifestyles. And then if when the architecture is all covered by their lifestyle and living stuffs, that must be the most beautiful moment, I believe. So I'm really, really looking forward to see how these platforms could create the whole building, 50 meter high rise, all covered by the living stuffs. So this is the Budapest project. This is the program is a bit complex. The music museum and the music hall, performance halls, hall, and music education programs. But mainly, for us, mainly the music performing space was a very, very attractive point. The site is in the park. This is a huge park in the city of Budapest. But the park is old park, so it is quite like a really natural, looks like a natural forest. And in the middle of that, our site. And then this is our proposals, like a floating roof.
Our translation was a bit too straightforward.
In this case, we
but the trees, tree trunks, tree crowns, to make it into the floating roof with many, many openings, perforating to the roof so that the sunlight is coming through it. And this open ground level, surrounded by the glass wall, could be the music performance spaces. So it is protected inside, but the sunlight is coming through it and open to the forest. This is the section. They request huge exhibition spaces, and we struggle how to do with this. There is two huge volumes and too much high ceiling height requested. So finally we decided to put it in the underground to protect the atmosphere of the forest. And then this ground level, this is the roof, this ground level open to the forest. It has an entrance space and a big music hall and the middle-sized lecture hall together. And these upper volumes, we have the education programs. This is more like an enclosed programs and the administration programs. So it is clearly divided, but mostly these open spaces on the ground level is the main space. The shape of the roof is a round, a pure circle shape, because it's in the middle of the park. So we like to invite people from various different directions. So I don't like to make the front side and back side. But actually, as you can see, it is already really surrounded by the huge trees. So you don't see exactly exterior. You don't see the exterior. This is the view we made, but it is not the realistic view, because we don't see this kind of exterior view. It's completely covered by the trees. And then we have many openings, but some of the openings has the trees going through it, existing trees going through it. So the location of some of the openings are really nicely fitting to the position of the trees. So the experience is you're walking in the forest, and then the forest situation and the roof situation, intersection of these areas, you walk through it. Gradually, from the nature to the architectures, gradually you walk like a transition phase. And then you are going under the canopy, but this is not still inside. This is huge outdoor spaces covered by just a roof. to create outdoor performance spaces. Because in the Budapest, yeah, in summertime it's quite hot, sunlight is strong, and then they have snows and showers. So we like to create those kind of a huge canopy areas. It's like the outdoor space, outdoor canopy protected spaces, but not like a forest, it's more like artificial forest. And then finally you come into the interior. So those kind of transitions from nature to the half nature to the architecture scenes is the point of this project. And this is the areas of the ground level. And these lines of the glass is because the glass is bended like this because of the acoustic effect. But it mainly it is quite transparent. And this is a view of the small lecture hall. It's quite open. And again, this is a bended glass. And of course, if you like to do this kind of a PowerPoint, you just close it by the curtains. But mostly, for example, music performance, it's just could be open to the forest. And maybe winter time, you can slightly see the surroundings. So in this case, yeah, it's rather straightforward translations from the nature into the architectures. But the experiences of the transition from the forest meandering to the transition areas of the trees and the roofs, and then going under the canopies. And even under the canopy, we plant some of the trees. And then you get into inside. But still, even inside, you see all the walls are glass, so you can feel you are open to the forest. This is now the last phase of the design, and will be completed in a few years. Okay, so this is the last project. This is in Paris, and huge competition, and finally we won. And the title is, in French, it's 1,000 trees, because we propose the like a floating forest in the city of Paris. It is like this. So you can see a huge forest. It is almost like a 35 meter high, so it's almost the height of the city of Paris, classical city of Paris. And then on the lower part, we also create the public forest. The location is here. This is like this is a Louvre, the museum. And then you have a Champs-Élysées, so they have a huge access from the Louvre.
And the requirement bodies are huge. So those kind of balances, and finally, as a strategy, we use the forest as a really actual use of the forest. So every time depending on situations, we go back from